Hi, YouTubers. Old Radio Al here. We got a crowded table today. Probably wondering what this is all about. Well, let me tell you. I was going to make this just a small segment and a vintage mashup about this little guy. It's a 1948 Motorola Model 5A7A. He's a little guy. I mean, there's my hand. I can just about cover him. Despite what John tells you, I'm not really that big. Anyway, like I was saying, this is a Motorola. It's a 5A7A from 1948. And Phil and I, SteelCity321PB, were commenting back and forth about the similarity between this little radio and his Marconi P20B. I thought I'd give Phil a look at this set. I don't know if he saw the previous video I did on it. Not too many people did. It was one of my least viewed videos. I don't know why. It's a cool little set. I thought, you know, maybe about doing a second chance video on some of the sets that didn't get much love. This one deserves it, but anyway, Motorola, they had some really innovative portables. The ones like this, and there were a few of them, I think, are really cool. This little set, you know, was under like $8. This is metal case, by the way, metal and plastic. Under $8 new. In 48, uses miniature tubes. And of course, the benefit of that is instant on. This radio's on and off switch is right up here. It's activated when you open the front cover, and that is the latch for the front cover, the little Motorola emblem. And it works like this. Anyway, I digress. I wanted to tell you about a little bit about all of these portables and kind of the evolution of portables, if you will. And, you know, like I said, this one got me thinking about how we've always wanted our music on the go, our radios on the go, I guess. And this Spartan Model 62 is from 1933. You've seen this one before. It's a good example. This one is AC only, but it is clearly a precursor to the modern portables. It's a little handle, and the front cover. You may have seen the video on this radio also. This is a Stuart Warner. This is like the 5A7A. This is from 1948, but vastly different. This type of radio was pretty common. This one is a model A6D1P3, I believe. And these were wooden boxes that are cloth covered, and it. It's a true portable. It works on both AC and battery. From there, another 1948 set. I guess when guys came back from the war, they really wanted portable radios. This is another Motorola set you've seen before. This is a 68L11. They're cloth covered that have a tinite coating. Again, it's an AC-DC set. And miniature tubes. And spin on. From there, the late 40s, the evolution was to this type, which you saw playing in the beginning. This is another Motorola. Motorola really made, I just like Motorola portables for some reason. This is a very space age looking radio, an asymmetrical front grille design. The rototenna, of course. And you've seen, I don't think you've seen this set before, but you have seen some of his brothers over there. At the other end of the portable type radio was a set like this, the
waitress said if it's a dia, if she'll be a my caramia, then I'll join in matrimony with the girl who serves spamoni, and Angelina will be mine. She'll alone let some out of my mind.
And that, of course, is a Zenith transoceanic. This one's an A600 from 1958. What a pain in the butt to restore this one was. But anyway, I think these were kind of portable and name only. That's a big set. Originally made for yachting, for DXing while at sea, I guess. Commander McDonald wanted that done. And then of course, in the evolution of portables was also this type. Yet another Motorola. This one's an X25E from 1961. And this was the kind that, every kid of my generation either had or wanted one of these. Had it in their pocket, riding around on their bicycle with their headphone, listening to their transistor radio. So yeah, portables have always, been something desired, and I guess they've really changed over the years. I don't have a boombox, that 80s step in the evolution of portable music. I don't have one of those. Modern portables from, a purely radio standpoint could be something like this little guy. A Grundig, the G8 Traveler, which I don't really use for listening to music much. I use it for shortwave DXing. The landscape's really changed, I guess, guys. There were other steps, like the cassette Walkman, and then later the CD Walkman. I think most people probably listen to portable music like this now on their smartphones. I doubt very many of them listen to Jolson on their smartphone, though. So, over the years things have changed, but I guess we really always wanted our music on the go, our newscast or whatever. Listen to it in bicycles. Listen to it in our cars. Listen to it on the beach. Like those people over there. Listen to it while jogging. You know, the iPod has really changed things. iPod and other MP3 players. You know, where's it going to go from here? You know, they're going to plant a microchip in your head and you know, press your ear and one ear for volume and one ear for tuning. I don't know. As for me, I'll still be listening to these old radios. You know, there's something to be said for style, and I think all of these guys really have it.
Just like my stepfather, that's amore.
That's amore.
When you dance down the street with the cloud at your feet.
As always, guys, thanks for watching, and more radios on the way.
In a dream, but you know.
I kissed you. Oh yeah. You.